Now come to this numerical. This numerical consists of lot of things, so please be attentive. First look at the circuit diagram. The circuit diagram consists of a source that supplying energy or power to the circuit, and the circuit elements having two resistors receive that energy and power in a certain amount of time.
Okay.
This portion belongs to power and this portion belongs to energy.
Okay.
Now the first question is, find the total power supplied by the source. Here is the source and source is supplying power. Okay. So we have to calculate total power supplied by the source. Okay. Total amount of power supplied by the source. And second question is, power delivered to the elements R1 and R2. And how much power is delivered across R1 and R2? Okay. So, first of all, these are the formulas for the calculation of power. P is equals to V into I, or is equal to I square R, or is equal to V square by R. As per convenient, we use the formula. Okay. And here we have a formula for energy. Electrical energy is equal to power into time. Okay. Now, here, first of all, I am going to calculate the power delivered by the source. So, what is given for the source? The potential difference. Okay. The potential difference across the source is 10 volt. It means V is given. Okay. Now, if I calculate I, the current drawn from the cell, okay, I, the current drawn from the cell, then we can easily calculate the power supplied by the source, V into I, okay. And I have already told you how to calculate the current drawn from the cell, okay. So we know that current drawn from the cell is equals to EMF of the cell, okay, and divided by the equivalent resistance of the whole circuit. What is the equivalent resistance of the circuit? So these two resistors are connected in series and their series combination, they are in series combination, so their equivalent will be 3 plus 2 5. Okay. So the EMF of the cell is 10 divided by equivalent resistance is 5. Okay. It means 2 ampere. So 2 ampere current is drawn from the cell. Now we can calculate the power supplied by the source. Okay. So we can calculate power supplied. Okay. This subscript S showing that this is the power supplied by the source. So, which will be equal to, from this formula, P is equal to V into I, V into I. So, V is the potential difference across the source, that is 10, is equal to EMF of the source, multiplied by the current drawn from the cell. This is 2 ampere. So, 10 to the 20 watt. Okay. So, 20 watt is the power supplied by the source. Okay. Now I am going to calculate the power delivered across R1 as and R2. Okay. So power delivered across R1 is equals to, okay. Now here we have two resistors, okay, connected in series, and we know that in series connection the current remains same. It means this current I, okay, this current I will pass through both of the resistors, okay, because both the resistors are connected in series. So I will pass through both of the resistors. So across R1 the current will be I, that is 2 ampere, and across R2 the current also remain same, 2 ampere. Now for this resistor R1, we have current and we have resistance. So in this formula of power, current and resistance are there, okay. So it is easy to apply this formula because we know the current through the resistance and the value of the resistance, okay. We know both of them, so we can easily find power if we use this formula, okay. So the power across R1, okay, will be equals to I square R, okay. What is the value of current flowing through R1? It is 2 ampere, so 2 squared multiplied by the value of resistance, that is 2, 2 to the 4 to the 8, 8 watt, okay. In the same way, we can calculate the power dissipated across R2. So the power across R2 will be equals to again I square R, okay, and I square means 2 square and R is equal to 3, okay. So this is the power dissipated across the second resistor R2, okay. 2 to the 4, 3 is a 12 watt, okay. Now look at the data. This is the power supplied, okay. This is the power supplied and this is the power dissipated, okay. And according to the conservation of energy, the power supplied must be equal to the power dissipated. Now add them and check. So 12 plus 8 is 20, 21. So it is true that the energy and power is conserved in this circuit, okay. And this is also the verification of conservation of energy also. So here the total power supplied is equal to the total power dissipated, okay. So this is how we calculate power supplied and power delivered, okay. Now come to this part, come to energy part, okay. Find the total energy supplied by the source in 10 seconds, okay. So time is given, time is 10 seconds. How much energy is supplied by the source in 10 seconds, okay. We know the formula, W energy, electrical energy supplied is equals to power supplied into time. How much power is supplied? 20. So it is equals to 20 into time is 10. So this will be equal to 200 joule, okay. 200 joule energy is supplied in 10 seconds by the source. And now how much energy is received by R1, okay. So the power received by R1 multiplied by the time, time is 10 seconds, okay. So what is the power dissipated across resistance R1? It is 8 watt. So 8 into time is 10 seconds, 80 joule. 80 joule energy is dissipated across R1, okay. And again calculate the energy across R2.
Okay.
How much energy dissipated across R2? Calculate the power dissipated across R2 multiplied by the time. And the power dissipated across R2 is 12 into 10, 120 joule. Okay. And when you add these two energies, which are dissipated across elements, it would come out to be 0, 0 and 2, 200. And you see that the total energy supplied by the cell or source is equal to the total energy dissipated across the elements. Okay. So this is the conservation of energy. Okay. So this is the way how to calculate energy